first date with Jessica. Well, we've talked about that enough over the years. It was a blind date with one other couple, first time we met. But I remember our second date, first date with just the two of us, and first date where we actually decided we wanted to see each other after having already met. And we went ice skating and had a good time. I can remember coming back to, she came to my place. I was living with Jim Dunn and Dan Caruso, remember that? And I can just remember throwing her over my shoulder at one point in the house after ice skating. She went to the bathroom and I burped really loud and she came out and was like, "What was that?" I'm sure it was all in good impression, right, babe? But then I can remember from the early days of dating, our drive, that was for the birds until I moved into Royal Oaks, cut it in half. And I think from that second date, first real date, I pretty much knew that this was going to go somewhere. This was going to be serious. I don't know when Jessica started to feel that way, but for me, I did. I felt like it was a beautiful girl, and she did love the Lord, and we had a good time together, the two times, and we had talked a little bit in between and started to do our IMing, which became a major part of our early relationship. Which I still have a lot of those items saved. And within that same year, that was March. And by November, I was asking your parents, how that went. But it's been now over a decade that we've been married, over 11 years that we've known each other. And I can say that Jessica has been a wonderful wife. You have been a wonderful mother, and I have been really blessed to be your husband, to be the father of your children, and to go through this life together, through all the good times, and not too many bad times, thankfully. And I look forward to the next decade, and potentially many, many more to come, Lord willing. I love you, babe. And I hope you enjoy this night, and I'm blessed.
The things I appreciate about my wife, you know, I was just thinking about this recently, and some of the things that are most I appreciate about her so much is how diligent she is, and we always joke about this, she's the packer and the planner, and that's what she does. She can coordinate things and organize things like that. It just amazes me. And you know, the way she takes care of our family and our home is it truly amazes me. So, Brooke, I just want to tell you how much I appreciate you. Maybe I don't say it enough, but you really are very important to me, and I want you to know how much I love you. And I love our family. I'm excited that we've expanded the clan by one, and what the future holds for us, what God has for us, is so much to look forward to. I love you, hon, and just want you to know that, and look forward to everything that's before us.
So, sweetie, I was told to do a serious video about this whole thing, so, it's hard for me to be serious. So, okay, here we go. The reason why I love you. I've asked myself that so many times, and it's just so natural for me to answer. And the truth of the matter is, I love you because you are everything that I'm not. Well, when it comes to a lot of things, when I met you, I fell in love with your innocence, with your, truthfulness, sincerity. And I wasn't any of those things. Your past was so different than mine. You were a good girl from a good family, and I was a hustler. And here I am thinking that God was gonna you know, marry me to just anybody, and I consider myself lucky with that. But then, you know, he brought me such a jewel. You are really, really a treasure, and I thank God every day for you.
When we first met, I wasn't saved, and we met in college, Kutztown University. And the first day that we met, Vivian thought that I was rude and obnoxious. I came off a little abrasive, kind of, you know, not very, very nice. And but over the coming months, we got to know each other because our roommates, my roommate and her roommate, they were in a little love triangle with somebody else. And whenever they went to you know, talk or something, Vivian would always come over to my room, or I would go over to her room, and we'd talk and get to know each other. And so I found myself thinking more and more about her, and I'll never forget Halloween 1995 was when I really realized. I was at a Halloween party, and it was actually hosted by a girl that I was, when I went to college, I was convinced that she was for me, but I couldn't get Vivian out of my head, and I kept thinking about her. And I couldn't wait to get home, so I left the party, and we stayed up pretty much all night talking, and we watched a Halloween marathon, and it was a lot of fun. And and that just to put the icing on the cake, she led me to the Lord. So honey, you are just without a doubt the most important thing in my life, and I love you. And you are just a fantastic woman, a great mother, an awesome wife, and I don't know what I would do without you. I love you.
Okay, so how did Karen and I meet? We know now, looking back, that it was a God thing. We were in college, and I was at a friend's house. It was a frat party, and it was like totally lame. There were no girls there, so my friend and I were leaving, and Karen shows up with her girlfriend, and we were like, hey, some girls, let's hang out. And it turns out that her dorm that night had a fire alarm, and it wasn't just an alarm, it was like everybody had to leave. So they ended up coming to this party they knew about, and that's how I even met her. And of course, I was just looking to hook up. She was completely disgusted by me. She had no interest whatsoever. but she was taking Italian, so I offered to tutor her. She didn't want me to tutor her. There was no interest. But the mutual friend that we had, whose house we were at, gave me her number. And I actually was angry with myself for even having it. I didn't want a girlfriend. I just couldn't stop thinking about her. This girl for weeks was on my mind, and I didn't know why, and I even hid her number from myself. I put it under a pile of books and everything. But eventually I did call her and asked her out, and the rest is history, divine history. So Karen, you know that I love you. You know that you're everything to me. And you know the song that I picked out for our wedding. I knew I loved you before I met you, and that's the truth. And I love that song because I did know who you would be, and what I wanted, and what I thought my wife would be, and you're everything and more. And I just want you to know that.
All right, Aaron. You know I love you. I try to tell you that many times every day, but Honestly, I do love you so much. I feel like in a lot of ways you're my conscience. I know how to follow the Lord, but I feel the way you love people and the way you have such a tender heart towards people. It influences me, and I need that in my life. I love the way you are with people, the way you do love people. I love your correctable spirit that you just desire to change in your life, and what a rare quality that is, to want to change and then to actually change. And you know, just seeing the work that God has been doing in you over even just the years that I've known you has just really been a great thing to see. I love you. I'm happy that you are the mother to our children, and I just love you a lot.
Hey, honey. Love you very much, and I hope you enjoyed everything that we did for you, and all the planning and everything like that. I can still remember the first time that I saw you pulling into Houghton, young and stupid and immature, you in the white Oldsmobile that we named Samantha, that we totaled on our way back from a basketball tournament. You were beautiful, and I was just so focused on what I needed to do and school, and how just getting to know you in the Czech Republic, playing ping pong late at night at the youth center, and just spending so much time with you, over that, week or 2 weeks, I forget. And coming back and just, that whole summer, just talking for hours every night on the phone about everything. And going from that to where we are now, I can say that I'm still excited to be married to you, and the new things that I learned, that I was just when you think you know everything there is to know about someone, I always seem to learn more, and it's so exciting, and I love just hanging out with you and spending time with you and nights like this. It's been a roller coaster ride for our relationship, but there's no one I'd rather have in the seat next to me to go through the highs and lows of going down the roller coaster with our hands up, or when things get a little rocky and scary, being able to hang on to someone next to me and being able to go through that together. And I love you so much. I'm so proud of you. I'm so proud of the mom that you are. I'm so proud of everything that you do for me. I would be lost. I would be an unscheduled mess without you, and I know the kids really need you, and I really need you, and I love you so much, and I can't wait for the next 50 years or however long that we have to just learn more about each other. And I love you, honey, and I care about you.
Probably, I think what first really caught my attention about Denise, not because I thought she was good-looking, because she definitely is amazingly good-looking. It was how she treated me when we first met. By way of background, most people don't know this story, but I've had members of my own family, women in my own family, who would say to me, Scott, I would never marry somebody like you. So it was kind of grew up with the idea that, I got to kind of really try to impress somebody. You got to really be good and really wow somebody. When I first met Denise, I probably had the most embarrassing experience I ever had meeting somebody. We're on our way into this mall to go to this restaurant, and twice on the way to this restaurant, my knee gave out. Like, no reason. Like, to this day, I can't tell you why that even happened. And each time it happened, it was just like, oh, I can't believe this is happening. And I was getting more and more embarrassed. Well, we get to the restaurant, we make a reservation, we're waiting for them to call our table. And I take the pager they gave me and I put it in my back pocket. Forgot that it was there. When it went off, it freaked me out. And jumping up out of the seat and what was this going on, and discovered it was the pager. Even more embarrassment on top of it. And so later on, Denise and we're just chatting, and she said to me she thought that it was really cute, which I was shocked to hear. Because so you said you need to, you know, impress people, you need to wow the women and stuff like that. And she was absolute opposite of any other girl that I can recall that I ever, you know, dated. And that so drew me to her. And yeah, we had broke up for a bit, but a couple years later we did get back together again. And I knew the next time around when we did get back together again that I wasn't going to let this girl go, because there was something very different, very unique about her. And I think just because she knows what love is about and really conveyed to me in a very tangible way that, you know, to this day it still blows me away, like the kind of person that she is, and her character, her integrity, her forgiving spirit. She's just so much fun to be around. And, you know, I could be in a room with her, you know, not doing anything, and I'll have a great time, because I know I'm with the most amazing woman that I think ever walked in the face of this earth. So to all your other guys' wives, yeah, whatever. My wife is awesome.